To make a new map, go up to where it says File and click New. Next, we need to make some ground for your person to stand on. Click on the Block tool on the left-hand side of the screen. Drag it out in one of these three views, which happen to be 2D views of your map. Once you're done, click Enter. To see what you've done so far, move your mouse over the top left screen, this happens to be the 3D view of your map, and press Z, or Z if you say it wrong. You can now navigate around your map using WASD, and the arrow, no you can't, WASD. Your map should currently look like this. To add textures onto it, click Camera and choose 3D Shaded Textured Polygons. This is the best for most cases. This is the level you've made so far. To make a character that you can play in the level, click on the Entity tool on the left-hand side of the screen. Click on the block you made. This is the person. What he looks like depends on which game you're mapping for. I'm mapping for Counter-Strike Source, so he looks like a terrorist. To play the level so far, press F9. It'll tell you to save your map because you haven't saved it yet. I'm going to call it First. Click OK to render your map. Well done, you're now playing your first level, but oh no, there's lots of blurry stuff. To fix this, we need to seal in your map so that there's no way that it can escape into the blackness outside. There are many ways to seal in your level. For the sake of this tutorial, the easiest one is to select the block tool and to make a big block around your entire level. Now, a lot of people will complain about this method, but for your first map, it doesn't matter. Press Enter to make it. Once you've made sure that everything is inside, go up to where it says Tools and click Make Hollow. I tend to use -32. Let's play the game again. Press F9. Click OK. Wait. That's much better. Your map now works. Now it's time to make it look better. At this stage, I recommend just making a small level using the block tool. To make more blocks, simply drag out more and press Enter when you're happy. With this, you can make an entire level. You can change the position or the size of them by dragging them out and dragging them around in the editor. Once you've made them and you want to select them again, click on the selection tool. With this you can select anything you've made in the level and you can move it round, resize it, or delete it with the delete button. Next, let's try different textures. Say you want a grass texture. Click on the block tool again, and where it says browse on the right hand side of the screen, choose another texture. If you want a grass texture, type in grass into the filter box at the bottom and choose the texture that you want. Some work better than others. Once you've selected it, just make the block as normal and it should have the new texture. There. To change the texture of a block you've already made, click on the selection tool and select the block you wish to change. Now click on this button here, Apply Current Texture. With this you can retexture everything in your level if you want. If you want to change the texture of one single side, click on the Toggle Texture Application tool. With this, you can select individual sides. You can select more than one by holding down Control. Once you've got all of them selected, you can choose the texture you want to change them to and click Apply. To make it look as if your level is outside, go to Browse and type in Skybox. Go to the bottom of this list and there should be this texture. Choose it. Now apply it to the area that you want to look as if it's outside it. Blah, 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 blah. Now apply this texture to the outside of your map. Like so. This world will now look like it's outside. And that's all I'm going to talk about in this tutorial. Whoops. I will now make a small example map using what we've learnt. If you really want to download this map, I've got a link to it in the description of this video. If not, I don't blame you. You can watch some more tutorials where I make this map look better. It's all in the description. Have fun.